Hello again. Our story today begins a little while after Ringo transferred to Tamo no Rin High. Seriously, slow down. You're stressing me out here. Jeez, not like we have anywhere important to be. Life likes to surprise us sometimes. Just when we think we're comfortable, bam, game changer. And all we can do is stand there and take the moment in.
We've been terrorized!
What a nightmare.
Maybe someone should call the police.
I had a feeling this would happen one of these days.
There's not even a fence. This field's completely vulnerable.
Did anybody here happen to see who did this? If so, speak.
I saw it. Yes, the perpetrator of this foul deed was a child.
Child?
He was wearing a gray coat or some such thing, running off with his arms filled with our vegetables.
Wait, what time would you say this happened?
I believe it was yesterday evening on my way back home after I finished feeding the cows. I would say it was a touch after 8 o'clock. The fiend dropped this.
It would seem you're telling the truth.
The question is, what are you planning to do? If it was a child, then you have to impartially investigate the facts and figure out his motives.
Yes, we have to figure out what happened fast. Do you think it's possible the boy did this because he's starving?
Please, sir. Please, may I have some more?
Ah! Don't you people get it? If we don't get to the bottom of this, these kids will keep coming around and eating all our vegetables willy-nilly with no consequences at all!
Hey, you guys!
The adults are talking, Minori! In case you haven't noticed, I am attempting to prevent what could become a major crisis!
Could have been a monkey.
A what?
I'm picking up a monkey vibe, aren't you?
This has monkey written all over it.
You're wrong! He was walking on two legs!
Wild monkeys may not be able to walk for miles upright like that, but they can do it!
It's true, I've seen them run off with whole watermelons before!
Wait, you've seen this with your own two eyes?
Minori and I are seriously from the middle of nowhere, so we saw crazy stuff all the time.
Dogs, monkeys, pheasants, you name it!
What is this, Japanese folk hour?
Oh, man, I'm just glad there wasn't a starving orphan.
Okay, everyone, we're done!
What's going on?
Oh, we're just thinking we're in for a bit of a battle here.
Let's do this.
All right. Welcome to the first ever A Monkey Showed Up and We're in a Jam, so now we have to come up with some countermeasures meeting. Now, why don't we all take turns making suggestions?
Where I come from. If we want to keep varmints from treating our crops like a buffet, we build an electric fence.
Yeah, but couldn't the animals get hurt?
It'll shock them, but they won't die.
Yes! Commit fence building at once!
Well, the idea itself isn't all that bad. I'm afraid it's impractical.
Yeah? Why's that?
We're flat broke.
That sucks!
He's clearly hungry, so why don't you just feed him?
Huh?
It does seem like the humane thing to do.
I get it now. You're saying if we stuff his belly till he can't eat another bite, then he won't need to mess up our fields anymore and we can get back to business as usual.
That is the greatest idea of all time!
Not bad, but there's only one problem. The food supply isn't his only target. He's been ransacking our potted plants as well. It seems pretty obvious to me the beast is doing this for fun, so I'm not sure a full belly will stop him.
So much for that. Listen up. I've spent my whole life battling these monkeys. I know where their weaknesses lie. Sheer brute force is the only way to stop these evil bastards. Behold! I can use Super Hitoshi with 30 times the power of the old Hitoshi, a weapon guaranteed to blow his monkey butt back to the jungle!
Oh my, that's an awful big gun you have.
This bad boy can launch up to 30 fireworks simultaneously!
What the heck? Well, that's weird.
Maybe the gunpowder's wet or something. Here, let me take a look.
Kids, believe me when I tell you this. It's never a good idea to stare down the barrel of a loaded gun.
Whose idea was this?
Because you have all failed miserably, I will now unveil to you my super secret plan!
All right, then. Spill the beans.
Listen, Vulgarians. As you know, humans and monkeys are both primates. If we deal with this rationally, I think you'll see that—
Hell no!
Whatever. It was ingenious. You can't deny
Hunter.
That humans and monkeys are both primates.
Yes. He's just one monkey. It's not like a whole army. We should be able to dispose of it easily.
Dispose?
Yeah, Kay. I know we've got to put a stop to this, but won't you feel bad about having the monkey killed?
Farming is a brutal business. Truth is, I'm prepared to do whatever it takes to solve this problem.
Yeah, okay.
As a matter of fact, I know a skilled hunter. He's just the man for the job.
Hello, my name is Omori.
Wow. Guy's a total creep.
Whoa! Keep those thoughts to yourself!
No, she's right. The man's a troll.
Hey, did you not hear what I just said?
Surely this isn't your man. You claimed you knew a skilled hunter. I'll wager the only skill this man possesses is finding the nearest box of snack cakes.
People are only 90% looks, which means there's 10% of them that'll take you by surprise. Omori might be large, but he's large and in charge.
And he's a blowgun pro!
You've gotta be kidding me!
Oh no, it's no joke. It's real. Yours truly is the founder of the Omori School of Blowgun Arts.
That's not weird. Okay, then. If you're a master, where are your blowguns?
Right here!
Huh?
Seriously? Those are your blowguns?
They're my super stealthy sniper blowguns.
Sniper blowguns?
Right! Of course they are! Didn't mean to doubt you or anything, it's just when I first saw them, I kind of thought they looked a bit like anime wall scrolls.
Oh! Actually, that's precisely what they are.
Huh?
These puppies make decent blowguns if you remove the thumbtacks, take them off your wall, and roll them up.
Yeah, I can see they do. So, Mr. Omori, if you don't mind me asking, with your homemade blow dart wall scroll guns, what do you typically hunt?
Just the occasional real lifer.
Neat. Swell. So I gotta ask this. Your job. I mean, when you're not out there tracking down real lifers, do you have a job that pays you money?
I'm unemployed. This potent little narcotic will send even the hardiest knuckle-dragging primates on a one-way trip to monkey heaven, if you catch my drift. Its name? Well, if I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Look!
I mastered my dart gun technique by sucking on pasta several hours a day. I call this specific blowing method the deep throat.
Cool name.
It's in the throat. You have to keep it relaxed.
I don't want to know!
Come on!
All right, time to show this monkey whose turf this really is!
Yeah, spank that monkey!
thing. He's hurt. Kosaku?
No, Ringo, I'm sorry. But we can't show him mercy.
He's right. Our responsibility is to protect these fields.
I know not how this vile beast was separated from his tribe, nor do I know why he has invaded our grasslands, but I do know this. The time to consider the manner of his disposal is upon us.
Maybe try not to sound so excited about it.
Okay, what a fool thou art. I take no pleasure in killing beasts, only in caging them. I have a dear friend who works at the zoo. I've requested that a comfortable dwelling be prepared for him.
I'm a bit surprised. That's very kind.
You see, currently they only house female monkeys at this zoo, so when he joins them, he'll be in monkey heaven in the best way. He'll perform husbandly duties and live life like a king.
Wow, what a relief.
This'll give a whole new meaning to the phrase, monkey see, monkey do.
Great plan. Thanks. I owe you for this one.
Charitable deeds done in the name of self-gratification or seeking attention are not genuinely charitable deeds. I did what I did for the monkey and the monkey alone. I do not require your thank you, thank you.
I was right.
Coming! Hey, Kosaku, what's up?
Mind if I come in for a second? There's something we need to talk about.
Oh, come back in 1 hour, please!
Actually, now would be better.
But this is very last minute, and I have so many things I need to get ready! Just, wait right there!
1 hour?
Yo-yo?
All set!
Can I come in now?
Yes, I want you to come inside.
Did you redecorate or something?
Yes, I did. But there's no need to be nervous. Would you like to take a hot shower?
No, I'm okay.
You filthy boy! So you'd rather do it down and dirty then?
Kay, you're here.
Wait, Kay?
Yeah, I invited him to join us. Come on in!
Thanks for having me. Whoa!
She just redecorated her room.
This was our moment. I really thought it was.
Yeah, I see that.
So, what's up? You wanted to talk about something?
Oh, right. It's about Ringo, actually.
Good night.
What?
Die!
Why are you freaking out? I haven't even given you the details yet.
Die in a fire in rotten hell!
Rude? You don't even know what I'm gonna say!
Man, she's gonna stab you one of these days.
How come? Whatever, I'm done trying to figure it out. Just look at this.
Oh, cool. This is a Yuka Kusakabe DVD.
I thought I threw those things away, but I guess someone had a secret stash.
I used my allowance and bought some replacements. Anyway, take a good look at Yucatan. Notice anything strange?
Well, this may seem pretty obvious, but she's acting so friendly. The Kinoshita I know doesn't have a happy bone in her entire body.
He's right. She's so smiley, it's weird.
Bingo! This is all about her smile! Think about it for a minute. The girl hasn't smiled once since she got here. She didn't crack a smile in her first class. She didn't so much as smirk during the whole panties thing, or during dinner, or during the king game, or when she survived the contest with Minori. Not even when the damn monkey's life was saved.
That's true, but her happiness here could just be part of her act, right?
You may be onto something, but still, there's a person living with us who's so down they never smile at all. Don't you think that's sad?
Yeah, actually, it really is.
I know, right?
If you need smiles, then have no fear. The comedy cavalry has arrived. Fancy running into you here, Kinoshita. Anyway, how would you feel about watching me perform a little trick? Dark matter!
Step it up a notch. Well, hello!
Minori! Damn you for making me jealous right now! But keep up the good work!
So tell me, how do you like my technique? Here, try this on for size.
Okay, how about a little communication? Talk to me. How else will I know what you like?
I'm sensitive.
The body doesn't lie. There's no reason to hold back. Just give yourself over to absolute pleasure.
I give myself, I do!
Come on now, show me that smile. Huh?
Now it's my turn to show you what I've got. You gonna tell me what's going on?
Look, I'm sorry. I really am. It's just you always seem so glum all the time. I guess I'm worried life here isn't really doing it for you.
I see. So this whole thing was about getting me to smile?
Dumb, I know. We didn't mean any harm by it, I swear, but we did get a little carried away, didn't we?
I can't smile.
Huh?
I try. But it doesn't work. At first, they said my expression seemed a little stiff and that I needed to relax. But I really didn't think much of it. I figured I was just tired. But over time, I completely lost the ability to smile. Eventually, I couldn't summon up other expressions either. The way things were, it didn't make sense for me to stay where I was. So I left just like that monkey.
Yeah, but in the end, the monkey found a safe place where he belonged. So you can too.
That's nice, thanks. But there's no point.
How can someone not be able to smile? It just doesn't make any sense.
I'm guessing it's psychological. That's the only explanation I can come up with. Maybe it was all too much for her. Maybe she got burnt out living in the limelight and always trying to meet other people's expectations.
She needs rest. That'll make her go back to normal, won't it?
Well, one can always hope.
I want her to smile again.
Huh?
Do you think it's selfish of me to want that for her? If it is, maybe I don't care.
Kosaku. Kosaku.
Whoa, who are you?
Do you not recognize me? Silly. I am Gaia.
Gaia?
Yes. I've come to deliver a message.
What message?
You must remember, Kosaku. Remember what mankind has done to me. Remember your ties to the soil. Please. Whatever the future holds, stand firm. Gaia is always with you, my friend. Till the end of time. Listen and you will hear me, imploring you to honor the land.
Oh, don't leave me here! Please, Gaia!
What was all that? Wacky. Remember what mankind has done to me. Guys, I think I'm gonna take Ringo to you know where. I really want to show her that soil.
Good idea. After all, she does have something in common with it right now.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe seeing the field and hearing a positive message would help her realize there's always hope.
Schools like ours have things called agricultural clubs, or ag clubs for short. Well, at any rate, we're headed to the site of a project we inherited from some former students.
A project?
Yes. And if you're willing, we'd like for you to join in.
This is it?
Yep.
Not the tomato field over there?
Nope. Here first.
Try touching the soil.
Right now?
Yeah.
It feels hard and dry.
Mm-hmm. The reason it feels that way is because the soil is dead.
It's dead?
It's a figure of speech. Crops won't grow here in its current condition.
That's so sad.
It's replant failure. Remember, Miss Becky talked about it.
If you continue to grow the same plant in the same soil over and over, eventually it won't grow anymore.
Yes, that's exactly right. People try to get around this problem. They use chemical fertilizers to try to stimulate new growth, but that only leads to disease and winds up damaging the environment. What you're seeing is the result of a vicious cycle.
Will the soil ever go back to normal again, or is it dead forever?
The process takes time. This field started out with that very same soil. It's been there since the very beginning. Previous ag clubbers started this project, and we inherited it. They worked for 7 years, day in and day out. Now it's our turn.
7 years?
It's not fixed. There's still a lot to do to get this soil back to normal. But even though this soil has a long way to go, this field is slowly improving, doing her best to live on the land she's got.
So, eventually this place will be reborn? Tomatoes look good. Can I eat one?
What? Now?
I'd like to.
Sure. Why not? Here.
It's bitter.
Yeah, that's because it's not ripe just yet.
Still, I'll eat it.
Huh?
Yep, definitely bitter.
Told you.
Yeah, but I like it.
Whoa! You...
What?
Wait! This one's more ripe! Here, it'll taste way better!
Mine is even riper than hers.
No, no, no! Stick with mine! It's definitely juicier than Kay's! Mm. Take it!
Mine is fresher!
Food made with love, love of the earth, love of people, spreads happiness. The secret? Reminding yourself that it's nature's gift. Working the land is one of the greatest joys life has to offer. One day, I hope you'll experience that joy firsthand. Farming's 5 Top 4.
The only skill this man possesses is finding the nearest box of snack cakes.
People are only 90% looks, which means there's 10% of them that'll take you by surprise. Omori might be large, but he's large and in charge.
And he's a blowgun pro!
You've gotta be kidding me!
Oh no, it's no joke. It's real. Yours truly is the founder of the Omori School of Blowgun Arts.
That's not weird. Okay then, if you're a master, where are your blowguns?
Right here!
Seriously? Those are your blowguns?
They're my super stealthy sniper blowguns.
Sniper blowguns?
Right, of course they are. Didn't mean to doubt you or anything, it's just when I first saw them, I kind of thought they looked a bit like anime wall scrolls.
Oh, actually, that's precisely what they are.
Huh?
These puppies make decent blowguns if you remove the thumbtacks, take them off your wall, and roll them up.
Yeah, I can see they do. So, Mr. Omri, if you don't mind me asking, with your homemade blow dart wall scroll guns, what do you typically hunt?
Just the occasional real lifer.
Neat. Swell. So I gotta ask this. Your job. I mean, when you're not out there tracking down real lifers, do you have a job that pays you money?
I'm unemployed. This potent little narcotic will send even the hardiest of knuckle-dragon primates on a one-way trip to monkey heaven, if you catch my drift. Its name? Well, if I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Look!
I mastered my dart gun technique by sucking on pasta several hours a day. I call this specific blowing method the deep throat.
Cool name.
It's in the throat. You have to keep it relaxed.
I don't want to know!
Come on.
All right. Time to show this monkey whose turf this really is.
Yeah, spank that monkey!
Poor thing. He's hurt. Kosaku?
No, Ringo, I'm sorry. But we can't show him mercy.
He's right. Our responsibility is to protect these fields.
I know not how this vile beast was separated from his tribe, nor do I know why he has invaded our grasslands, but I do know this. The time to consider the manner of his disposal is upon us.
Maybe try not to sound so excited about it.
Okay, what a fool thou art. I take no pleasure in killing beasts, only in caging them. I have a dear friend who works at the zoo. I've requested that a comfortable dwelling be prepared for him.
I'm a bit surprised. That's very kind.
You see, currently they only house female monkeys at this zoo, so when he joins them, he'll be in monkey heaven in the best way. He'll perform husbandly duties and live life like a king.
Wow, what a relief.
This'll give a whole new meaning to the phrase, monkey see, monkey do.
Great plan. Thanks. I owe you for this one.
Charitable deeds done in the name of self-gratification or seeking attention are not genuinely charitable deeds. I did what I did for the monkey and the monkey alone. I do not require your thank you, thank you.
I was right.
Coming!
Hello again. Our story today begins a little while after Ringo transferred to Tamo no Rinhai. Seriously, slow down. You're stressing me out here. Jeez, not like we have anywhere important to be. Life likes to surprise us sometimes. Just when we think we're comfortable, bam, game changer. And all we can do is stand there and take the moment in.
What a nightmare.
Maybe someone should call the police.
I had a feeling this would happen one of these days.
There's not even a fence. This field's completely vulnerable.
Did anybody here happen to see who did this? If so, speak.
I saw it. Yes. The perpetrator of this foul deed was a child.
Child?
He was wearing a gray coat or some such thing, running off with his arms filled with our vegetables.
Wait, what time would you say this happened?
I believe it was yesterday evening on my way back home after I finished feeding the cows. I would say it was a touch after 8 o'clock. The fiend dropped this.
It would seem you're telling the truth.
The question is, what are you planning to do? If it was a child, then you have to impartially investigate the facts and figure out his motives.
Yes, we have to figure out what happened fast. Do you think it's possible the boy did this because he's starving?
Please, sir. Please, may I have some more?
Ah! Don't you people get it? If we don't get to the bottom of this, these kids will keep coming around and eating all our vegetables willy-nilly with no consequences at all!
Hey, you guys!
The adults are talking, Minori! In case you haven't noticed, I am attempting to prevent what could become a major crisis!
No, could have been a monkey.
A what?
I'm picking up a monkey vibe, aren't you?
This has monkey written all over it.
You're wrong! He was walking on two legs!
Wild monkeys may not be able to walk for miles upright like that, but they can do it!
It's true, I've seen them run off with whole watermelons before!
Wait, you've seen this with your own two eyes?
Nori and I are seriously from the middle of nowhere, so we saw crazy stuff all the time.
Dogs, monkeys, pheasants, you name it!
What is this, Japanese folk hour?
Oh, man, I'm just glad there wasn't a starving orphan.
Okay, everyone, we're...
You gonna tell me what's going on?
Look, I'm sorry. I really am. It's just you always seem so glum all the time. I guess I'm worried life here isn't really doing it for you.
I see. So this whole thing was about getting me to smile?
Dumb, I know. We didn't mean any harm by it, I swear, but we did get a little carried away, didn't we?
I can't smile.
Huh?
I try, but it doesn't work. At first, they said my expression seemed a little stiff and that I needed to relax. But I really didn't think much of it. I figured I was just tired. But over time, I completely lost the ability to smile. Eventually, I couldn't summon up other expressions either. The way things were, it didn't make sense for me to stay where I was. So I left just like that monkey.
Yeah, but... in the end, the monkey found a safe place where he belonged, so you can too.
That's nice, thanks. But there's no point.
How can someone not be able to smile? It just doesn't make any sense.
I'm guessing it's psychological. That's the only explanation I can come up with. Maybe it was all too much for her. Maybe she got burnt out living in the limelight and always trying to meet other people's expectations.
She needs rest. That'll make her go back to normal, won't it?
Well, one can always hope.
I want her to smile again. Huh? Do you think it's selfish of me to want that for her? If it is, maybe I don't care.
Kosaku! Kosaku!
Whoa! Who are you?
Do you not recognize me? Silly. I am Gaia.
Gaia?
Yes. I've come to deliver a message.
What message?
You must remember, Kosaku. Remember what mankind has done to me. Remember your ties to the soil. Please. Whatever the future holds, stand firm. Gaia is always with you, my friend, till the end of time. Listen and you will hear me, imploring you to honor the land.
Oh, don't leave me here!
Please, Gaia! Gaia!
What was all that? Wacky. Remember what mankind has done to me.
K.
guys, I think I'm gonna take Ringo to you know where. I really want to show her that soil.
Good idea. After all, she does have something in common with it right now.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe seeing the field and hearing a positive message would help her realize there's always hope.
Schools like ours have things called agricultural clubs, or ag clubs for short. Well, at any rate...
Hey, Kosaku, what's up?
Mind if I come in for a second? There's something we need to talk about.
come back in 1 hour, please!
Actually, now would be better.
But this is very last minute, and I have so many things I need to get ready! Just, wait right there!
1 hour?
Yo-yo?
All set!
Can I come in now?
Yes, I want you to come inside.
Did you redecorate or something?
Yes, I did. But there's no need to be nervous. Would you like to take a hot shower?
No, I'm okay.
You filthy boy! So you'd rather do it down and dirty then?
Kay, you're here.
Wait, Kay?
Yeah, I invited him to join us. Come on in.
Thanks for having me.
Whoa!
She just redecorated her room.
This was our moment. I really thought it was.
Yeah, I see that.
So, what's up? You wanted to talk about something?
Oh, right. It's about Ringo, actually.
Good night.
What?
Die!
Why are you freaking out? I haven't even given you the details yet.
Die in a fire in rotten hell!
Rude? You don't even know what I'm gonna say!
Man, she's gonna stab you one of these days.
How come? Whatever, I'm done trying to figure it out. Just look at this.
Oh, cool. This is a Yuka Kusakabe DVD.
I thought I threw those things away, but I guess someone had a secret stash.
I used my allowance and bought some replacements. Anyway, take a good look at Yucatan. Notice anything strange?
Well, this may seem pretty obvious, but she's acting so friendly. The Kinoshita I know doesn't have a happy bone in her entire body.
He's right. She's so smiley, it's weird.
Bingo! Hmm? This is all about her smile! Think about it for a minute. The girl hasn't smiled once since she got here. She didn't crack a smile in her first class. She didn't so much as smirk during the whole panties thing, or during dinner, or during the king game, or when she survived the contest with Minori. Not even when the damn monkey's life was saved.
That's true, but her happiness here could just be part of her act, right?
You may be onto something. But still, there's a person living with us who's so down they never smile at all. Don't you think that's sad?
Yeah, actually, it really is.
I know, right?
If you need smiles, then have no fear. The comedy cavalry has arrived. Fancy running into you here, Kinoshita. Anyway, how would you feel about watching me perform a little trick? Dark matter!
Step it up a notch. Well, hello!
Minori! Damn you for making me jealous right now! But keep up the good work!
So tell me, how do you like my technique? Here, try this on for size. Okay, how about a little communication? Talk to me. How else will I know what you like?
I'm sensitive.
The body doesn't lie. There's no reason to hold back. Just give yourself over to absolute pleasure.
I give myself, I do!
Come on now, show me that smile. Huh?
Now it's my turn to show you what I've got.
No! Don't do this! Please, I'm drooling! I'm drooling all over the place! I think I'm gonna pee my pants!
What's going on?
Oh, we're just thinking we're in for a bit of a battle here.
Let's do this.
All right, welcome to the first ever. A monkey showed up and we're in a jam, so now we have to come up with some countermeasures meeting. Now, why don't we all take turns making suggestions?
Where I come from,
If we want to keep varmints from treating our crops like a buffet, we build an electric fence.
Yeah, but couldn't the animals get hurt?
It'll shock them, but they won't die.
Yes! Commence fence building at once!
Well, the idea itself isn't all that bad. I'm afraid it's impractical.
Yeah, why's that?
We're flat broke.
That sucks!
He's clearly hungry, so why don't we just feed him? It does seem like the humane thing to do.
I get it now! You're saying if we stuff his belly till he can't eat another bite, then he won't need to mess up our fields anymore and we can get back to business as usual!
That is the greatest idea of all time!
Not bad, but there's only one problem. The food supply isn't his only target. He's been ransacking our potted plants as well. It seems pretty obvious to me the beast is doing this for fun, so I'm not sure a full belly will stop him.
So much for that! Listen up. I've spent my whole life battling these monkeys. I know where their weaknesses lie. Sheer brute force is the only way to stop these evil bastards. Behold! I can use Super Hitoshi with 30 times the power of the old Hitoshi, a weapon guaranteed to blow his monkey butt back to the jungle!
Oh my, that's an awful big gun you have.
This bad boy can launch up to 30 fireworks simultaneously!
What the heck? Well, that's weird.
Maybe the gunpowder's wet or something. Here, let me take a look.
Kids, believe me when I tell you this. It's never a good idea to stare down the barrel of a loaded gun.
Whose idea was this?
Because you have all failed miserably, I will now unveil to you my super secret plan!
All right then, spill the beans.
Listen, Vulgarians. As you know, humans and monkeys are both primates. If we deal with this rationally, I think you'll see that—
Hell no!
Whatever. It was ingenious. You can't deny it.
Hunter!
Humans and monkeys are both—
Yes.
Primates.
He's just one monkey. It's not like a whole army. We should be able to dispose of it easily.
Dispose?
Yeah, Kay. I know we've got to put a stop to this, but won't you feel bad about having the monkey killed?
Farming is a brutal business. Truth is, I'm prepared to do whatever it takes to solve this problem.
Yeah, okay.
As a matter of fact, I know a skilled hunter. He's just the man for the job.
Hello, my name is Omori.
Wow, guy's a total creep.
Whoa, keep those thoughts to yourself!
No, she's right. The man's a troll.
Hey, did you not hear what I just said?
Surely this isn't your man. You claimed you knew a skilled hunter. I'll wager.